traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning. Your invested capital may be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose. And this video is not investment advice. So this video is another candlestick chart analysis video where I'm going to show you how I choose my trading setup. And I'm preparing to do a put here. Yes, I don't do a put. I waited for a better entry point. And now I'm doing a put because I'm pretty much sure that price will heading down further because we got here some kind of reversal. Then we got a strong downtrend, and now we are here in a consolidation area between the 50 EMA and the 100 EMA, and because of this kind of candlestick, which is telling me that we're heading down, I have done a put. So that's the reason why I do a put. That is how I read my the candlestick patterns, yes, and that is one of those things. You see, I have done this from the rejection from the round number here, yes, which I showing you in the last videos about the candle chart analysis, how you have to enter into any kind of trade. So let me see if I can explain this to you more in detail. So I will do here, first of all, this kind of stuff, why I did enter into this trade. And that is what I have explained. We got here an uptrend, yes, then we got here a reversal. So, and on this reversal here, after this kind of candle here, which broke, this candle broke the 50 EMA, and then it created this kind of inverted, this bearish hammer. And after the rejection, I entered into this trade. Yes, because I saw this wick here, which shows me we got rejected from the 1.1975 round number. And that's also a reason to enter into this put trade because of put option into a downtrend on resistance. Yes, that is how you have to do your trades. That is, but you have to be getting some kind of evidences, yes, that this kind of resistance is valid. And a wick is telling you already this, yes, and then I waited to get a better entry point because this could be also be a doji, yes, or something like this, because the price will oft retrace back. So that was this kind of scenario here in this kind of area. I would do probably only this kind of trade here, this of the rejection after this kind of long leg doji after this downtrend. I would enter into this trade on the rejection from the 50 EMA, yes, and then I would do here probably not anymore any kind of trade because it would be almost too risky to enter, for example, in this one here, yes, because it could be also retraced from the one deviation because you see it's almost flat and that means ranging mode, yes, and that's the reason why I would not enter into this kind of trade. So let me see if I can show you some more trading setups which I would do. So you understand it better. But you see, I'm doing those kind of trades almost always. Yes, because I wait for those kind of, okay, we got here this time. Let me see, that was this one which I have shown you already. This one here, that would be one of those trading setup which I would trade. Then I would here probably doing this kind of trade here after this engulfing candle. Yes. It's a little bit more risky because the wick is small, but we are far away here. You see, this engulfing candle broke the 20 EMA. That is what all is about. All those things which I'm explaining are based on those things which I have explained in the ebook, yes. And in the ebook, I have explained also that you need the force keys, yes. You need the trend, you need the key level, you need the candlestick pattern, and you need the rejection, yes. And then you can enter without any kind of problem into a trade. So I would do probably this kind of trade here because we have here the round number. Yes, this is a round number here, yes, on this high. So I would enter into this trade here because of this engulfing candle again, yes, which is telling me that we are heading down. Maybe also here some kind of a double top here at this round number. So then I would do no trade anymore. You see, the market is not so nice this this morning. So and then I would do this kind of trade here for sure, yes, because here we have a harami, a bearish harami, yes. So, this is a beautiful Rami combined with a tweezers top, yes, here. And that was the reason why I would enter into this trade, because this is a really nice and strong reversal signal. I have to explain this also often in some other videos, yes. A bearish Harami, a bullish Harami are really strong reversal signals, and that's the reason why I would enter also in this kind of trade. So let me see if I can show you some more. So we have another one. So we got to see, we have here an uptrend. So let me see if I can show you here's also some trades which I would do, but this is low volume. So I think here is not so many opportunities. Here is consolidation area, and that would be already a bad point. You see, also this kind of scenario here with it all EMAs together, yes, that is tricky. You see here how price after this candle, it should be a clear call, but because we have here all those kind of EMAs, price doesn't know what to do and got a consolidation area here, yes, consolidation, and then price will continue. Maybe I would do this call here after I would have seen this kind of retracement of this uptrend. So, and then here in this scenario, I would not do any kind of trade because you see it's low volume and almost everywhere those kind of consolidation areas at candlestick pattern, which are a clear sign that there will be a put, for example. Here it would be a put. That means you wait till the price goes up here to the opening price of the previous candle, yes, and then you enter into a put, and then you would get this also in the money. And that is why I don't recommend every time to enter immediately. Because you see, you can get caught by some kind of consolidation area. So, and then that one here would be also a trade which I would do here, this kind of Morningstar. Let me see, this would be a trade which I would do too. Yes, because we have here a nice area of the support level, yes, and so I would enter into a call on this rejection from this support area, yes, or trying to get a good entry point there. So, and that would be this one, and obviously this one here, after this engulfing candle, I would enter into this trade if I would understand that we have low volume, yes, and that would be the only reason why I would enter there, but else I would try to avoid this low volume market, because you see, it's tricky, it's almost tries to fool you, and you have to look for a better entry point. So let me see if I can show you here. You see, price was here trying to range in around the 200 EMA, but couldn't do this. And that is also, you see here, the market here is really not so nice. Yes, really bad in this opinion, my opinion. Yes, because you see, you get here fooled. Yes, you can here get fooled often, but I would enter into this kind of trade of the 200 EMA. Yes. Because the 20 EMA is heating down, yes, and I would expect here on the rejection from the 200 EMA that there will be a reversal, and this reversal would take more than one candle, and you see it's holding here two candles. This kind of scenario I would try to avoid, because here we are already in between of those EMAs, that would be not so nice, but I would enter into this kind of trade, yes, after the reversal here from this uptrend reversal, and then this bearish hammer would tell me that the next candle will be a red one, and then I would enter on the rejection from above to below. So, and then I would also doing this trade here, yes, because after the downtrend is established, this candlestick is telling me that we are heating down further, and you see on this level, on the rejection here, from this level here, you could enter into a put, yes, and that would be nice too. So, and then I see here no other opportunity, those candlesticks here, that was what I have explained to you before, the retracement here in between, and that was already this. You see, in the morning hours when the market is opening, it's not so nice, because market is really slowly, and you have to wait a little bit more to get to good opportunities, yes, and then you have also to get a higher entry point. or lower entry point to be on the safety side. Yeah, it's on to get a margin of safety. So, and before this, okay, here we have some more, which I can show you also. So I would do, for example, this kind of scenario here, this candle, I would trade this kind of candle here on the rejection from below to above, because this candle would tell me that we're heating up further. Yes, after this candle, I would not trade anymore. Yes, here in this kind of uptrend, because there would this was not unfolded. This unfolded not like I would expect. Yes, I would expect something like this or this here. Yes, some kind of this, but this is only a doji or a spinning top or whatever. Yes, and that is too weak to get into another call after this, yes, because price could reverse on at any point of this, yes, because you see we got here also selling pressure, which pushed the price down, yes, and that was this one. I would probably doing this kind of trade here because I love inverted bullish hammer, and here I would try to do again a call on the rejection, but it has to be obviously that there would be a nice rejection. So I would wait till price will come down, and then on the rejection above, I would enter into this call. But you have to be understand that this is already an area which could be a little bit more risky. So you have to understand the movement of the price. It has to go down first and then up, yes. And then after this, it has to go down again, and then on the up you would enter. So I would do this put here, yes, on this level here, because we have here a nice area, and these two wicks are doing here some kind of resistant area. And so I would enter here into this put after a rejection from above. So, and then all the rest here, I would try to avoid everything here, because here you see price is trying to play around the 200 EMA, and that is the only one which I would do would be this one, but I have shown this already before. So I think that would be enough. I have shown you those trading setups which I would have done. So, so I would say, if you like this video, do a like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe. And if you have something to say, let me say a comment or join the Facebook group. So I would say, stay safe and bye-bye.